The Gospel of the Lord. Thank you.
But it's about allowing God's word So give us your word, Lord. Oh.
look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring even greater holiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us the mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross, the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of the church, in which we show forth the passive sacrifice of Christ that has been handed out to us, and grant us that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted down until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking in this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us the bond of communion. Together with Francis, our Pope, and the Blades, our Bishop, with all other bishops, with priests and deacons, and before the entire people, grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember, my brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known, admit them to rejoice in the light of your gifts, and in the resurrection of him, the fullness of life. Grant also to us our earthly pilgrimages, Father, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live in it forever. There we may meet with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. Columbanus, the venerable Father of us, and with all the saints, we shall pray to the exaltation through Jesus Christ, our Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, like the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessing of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God.
Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you all. reminding to leave your mentality to receive the host and to walk away from the uniqueness that you consume, the blessed sacrament at that time. And also just encourage you to make sure that you can speak the line you might go to whichever one of us is available to you. For us as a parish, as a part of this community here in our local community, to be God's will. So, in the coming weeks and days, there will be more information for all of you who are worshiping at home. The letter will be put on our church website and social media tomorrow, so that you can have an opportunity to know what it means that Bishop Perry has said and what we're being invited to do in this moment. The other announcements are to be reminded that on Tuesday, we're always needing help at our food pantry to stock the shelves and make bags. So on Tuesdays at 1 p.m., we're here in the Black's House.
Thank you.